Alright guys, so there we go. I've just caught a Dover sole on the old ragworm. So this was about 31, 32 centimetres. I'm absolutely gassed with that. So I haven't recorded them, but I caught a really small pouting, a dogfish, and then I've got the white tingers down there, as well as Dan's one as well. So I'm taking this home, as well as the two whiting, and maybe anything else that we catch tonight. So I'm really chuffed with that, guys. Happy days. Woo, 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 let's go.
Alright everyone, so I'm at home now and I'm getting the sole ready and prepped up. So the first thing I'm going to do is to get ready to fillet this sole. I'm going to get a nice sharp knife, which I'm going to show you in a minute. I'm going to sharpen that first, because I've got a whetstone here, so I'm going to do that. And then we'll start again filleting. I've also got to descale the fish. It's already been gutted, I did that on the beach, so that's alright. And then we'll get to cooking it and eating it. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, it's something different on the channel. Obviously it's a catch and cook if you've done it before, but I hope you enjoy this one guys. So leave a like on the video, and I'd appreciate that. So here we go then guys, this is the knife of choice. So I've got a Victorinox, I think it's Fibrox, it's flexible sort of knife. So you got that, quite flexible. And I've got my whetstone here, so I'm gonna sharpen the knife up. So it's a really good knife to use for meat work sort of thing, as well as cutting fish. So I'm gonna get that sharpened up. Happy days. All right everyone, so first thing on the agenda is to descale the fish. So what I've got here is I've got a cheap tool of Amazon that I bought. Came in a pack of two, came with like tweezers and something else I think, so a pack of three. So you want to go upwards like that against the fish, and we'll take all the scales off. Especially if you do this with running water, but not like loads of water, just a slight trickle. So we'll get that done, and I'll come back to you when the fish is descaled. Fish here on the chopping board, it's all descaled, as you can see from there. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to cut these dorsal fins off, I think they're called. So it's best to use a pair of sharp scissors to do this. I'm just going to go all the way around there and cut these off, and I'm going to do that on both sides, and I'll be back with you when I've done that. Alright, so I've done that now. So the next stage, what you want to do is a little bit in front of the tail. You want to make an incision down here. You don't want to go all the way through, you just want to go under the skin. And I have done this before guys, so don't rip me in the comments, but you need to try and get your knife underneath the skin and get a little bit of that skin pried up. Be careful to watch your fingers on this. So there you go, that hopefully should be enough of the skin pulled up there. I'm getting a really sharp knife this, alright? So there you go, I've got a little bit of skin pulled up. And what hopefully I should be able to do is rather tough this, but if I'm lucky, I might be able to pull this off. Alright everyone, so a bit of a tough battle, but I managed to do it. I might have lost a little bit of meat down here, but I think that's just where the guts were, so that's alright. So I've got it de-skinned, dorsal fins cut off, and it's de-skinned on both sides, as you can see. So all the meat's exposed. So what I'm going to do now is I've got some Maldon sea salt. I've also got a bit of black pepper and some lemon here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to season the fish. So this is Maldon sea salt. This isn't essential at all, because I think there was a test that showed that putting this on before you cook in is completely pointless, but there you go, it's just salt anyway. We'll put a bit of salt on each side, get that nicely seasoned up, bit of the old pepper, but just season this to your taste really. I like a bit of pepper on there, so I'm going to do that. Sorry if the film's a little bit shaky, but I am doing this on myself as no one was around to help me at the point, but here we go. Getting that all nicely seasoned up, that's good to go. I'm gonna get that slapped in the pan, but first of all, gotta do this as well. Whack it into some flour. This will help it to have a crispy skin when it comes out. So what you do is get some flour, get that covered all over there. Making a bit of a mess, but oh well, that's all right. There we go, get it nicely covered in flour, and then shake off the excess. And we'll do that off camera, and then we'll get to cooking, guys. So I've got a nice big pan on here. Put a bit of olive oil, but you can use vegetable oil, something like that. And then I've got a bit of butter in there for flavour. So what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to get this heated up, get it nice and hot, and then we'll drop the fish in. So I've shaken the excess flour off the fish, and now I'm going to put it in the pan. There you go, there's a nice little sizzle. And what we're going to do is we're going to let him cook for about 5 minutes on each side. Flip him over, obviously. What we're looking for is the skin start crisping up, and then you should start seeing about halfway up the fish is starting to cook. So I'll let that cook for a bit and I'll be back with you in a minute, guys. So I've got this on about half heat at the moment. Looking lovely, guys. You can see the skin on the outside is turning white. We get a little bit of brown on this side, but it's lovely. So what I've got is I've got a burger toner here because I haven't got a fish slice. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to gently get under there. And then I'm going to flip the fish. You've got to be gentle with this, otherwise it could go wrong and the meat could come off. So gently try and flip the fish. There we go, and look at that, guys. Got some lovely crispy skin there. Oh yeah, I cannot wait to taste this. So I've got it flipped over, all's looking lovely right now. So what I do, I'm going to let that cook for a bit more, and I'm going to add the secret ingredient, which is a little squeeze of lemon. Wow, 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 guys, look at that, that is looking gorgeous. So I've left that cook for another couple of minutes. So what I'm going to do, got a nice wedge of lemon. I've cut the bottom off because it makes it easier to squeeze, actually. So I'm going to get a nice squeeze of lemon. There you go, nice squeeze of lemon. Give that a little mix around. That's going to be really yummy. The smell's coming off that. Getting the buttery richness, as well as that nice lemony citrus flavour. That's going to be gorgeous, guys. I can't wait to get this off out of the pan and on the chopping board again. Alrighty, so it's looking like it could be done. But what I'm going to do, just in case, just make sure I've got a nice probe here. So what you want to do, stick it right into the fattiest bit of the fish. And what you're looking for is a reading of 60 or above. There we go, guys. We've exceeded the 60 degree mark. So that fish is now cooked, fully cooked all the way through. So we're going to get off the pan, off the heat, and onto the chopping board and get it all served up and ready to go. So now that the old sole is out of the pan, what you want to do is you want to get your knife and you want to scrape away these bits down here, as there's the bones in here. So we'll do that on both sides. And the bones should come away. So I'll do that quickly off camera and I'll show you the results. So that's all done. So you can see that I've pulled all the bits off down the side. And that's got all the bones in it. And then what you're left with in the middle is two fillets on each side. So we've got some nice juicy fillets. There's my finger for size. So we've got lovely, lovely fillets of white fish there. Freshly caught last night. So this fish is no older than about, well, let's have a look. It's 3 o'clock now. I caught this for about 11. So, about 14, 15 hours old, this, guys, so that's as fresh as you can really get it unless you cook it on the night, but happy days, look at that. Gonna get those fillets cut off. I'll show you how to do that, potentially. But yeah, guys, look at that. Lovely, lovely white fish. So, to get these gorgeous fillets off, what you want to do is you want to get your knife. You want to run down the middle, just with a nice little cut down there. And then you want to slide your knife underneath, gently. And hopefully the fillet should come off with pretty good ease. Here it comes. And look at that, guys. That entire fillet right there has come off. And what you're underneath there is just bone. On the other side is obviously the fillet on the other side. So what I'm gonna do is gonna get all these fillets off. I'm so excited, this looks so good, guys. But yeah, I'm gonna get the rest of the fillets off and I'll show you the end result. I'm simply lost for words, everyone. Look at that, that came out a lot better than I thought it would. So on my left, we've got just the head and literally the bones completely stripped of all the meat. There's basically nothing on there apart from my little bit there that I've got off. Look at them. We've got some beautiful fillets here. Nice and crispy caramelized skin. That is absolutely gorgeous, guys. So get a little taste test on the go. I'll give it to the family. I won't record them because they won't like to be on camera. But look at that, guys. That is absolutely gorgeous. I'm absolutely chuffed with that. Get in. Caught that yesterday, last night, on the dinner plate tonight. That is brilliant. Happy days, guys. Here we go then, guys. So it's all paid off. Bit of Dover sole. Happy days. Let's have a little taste. That meat is so, honestly, that flesh is amazing. That's one of the tastiest fish that I've ever eaten. I said to Dan when he caught one and brought it into work to cook. Sole is one of the best flavorful fish ever. A little bit of lemon, that really brings out the flavor in the butter. That's seriously impressive, guys. So obviously, if you catch one like that, there's loads of videos online that will help you to fillet and cook them yourselves. So hopefully, I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you leave a thumbs up, tell me in the comments you enjoyed it. Maybe I'll do some more. I'm happy with that, guys. That's really tasty. See you in the next one. Thank you for joining me.